up, guys? So I have some news for you guys. You guys want to guess what it's gonna be, what the news is gonna be? Comment down below and let me know what you guys think I'm gonna tell you guys in this video. Well, the story I have for you guys today is, so this past Sunday, Darwin called and he was at the beach and he was stuck, so he called me to come and pull him out with this truck, because I've been pulling him out for like, I don't know, every time he gets stuck. And yeah, so I went to the beach. Long story short, I went to the beach and a few of my friends were there and we were just cruising and chilling and talking stories. And towards the ending of it, like, two of my friends got stuck, Darwin and Josh, if you guys remember Josh. So I had to pull them out and it was all good. We made it out, and after that I went to the gym, and while I was parking my truck at the gym, I noticed, here it is, it's gonna give you guys a hint, I noticed that my reverse wasn't engaging. So I put the car in reverse and nothing was happening. Then finally it went into reverse. I parked in the stall and I already knew that my transmission was going. Plus, when I was like driving on the beach too, I feel like my transmission was kind of overheating because I was smelling like a burning smell. And then on my way home, I was getting off the freeway and my engine just started like revving. My car started slowing down and my engine started revving, or like the RPMs kept climbing higher. And I just didn't want to pass like 25 miles per hour. And that's what you call, like, when, that's how you describe it, like when your transmission is slipping. So yeah, my transmission was slipping. So I made it home. I went to O'Reilly's to buy transmission fluid. And I tried replacing the fluid and stuff like that, but it still slips. So my transmission is pretty much done right now. On Monday, I tried to use it for work in the morning, but I didn't even pass like a couple miles till it started slipping again. So I turned around, came straight back home, and ever since then, this guy has been sitting here. As you can see, it's still dirty. I haven't had time to clean it yet. Don't at me. On top of everything, it's January and we started school again, so I have like school after work Mondays and Wednesdays now. So that doesn't help with me having time to do stuff. And yeah, that's pretty much an update on the truck. On the bright side, too bad I didn't have my camera with me when I went to the beach to go save them. I was trying to make a video of like how well these tires do in the sand. So a lot of you have been asking me on like on Instagram too, what kind of tires these are. These are the Arturo Trailblades Mud Terrains, and they're actually pretty good, not too bad. I didn't need to air down or anything on the sand, because when I had my other wheels, my 15s with the I had the BF Goodrich KO2s, all-terrains, and they did pretty okay in the sand as well. Sometimes I would have to air those down though, but with these tires right here, I didn't need to air down at all, and she went. So I'm gonna go ahead and finally power wash this truck. You guys are probably wondering that now, since my transmission is slipping, what am I gonna do now? You guys might be thinking, this guy's gonna 5-speed swap his truck, or he's gonna replace his transmission. But I'm sorry to say, no, I'm not. Hold on guys, I had to get the power washer out of storage. my own wheels, mini. But yeah, unfortunately I'm not doing any of those. I'm not 5-speed swapping it or replacing the transmission, because I don't have one, and because it's hard to find. I've been asking around ever since then and nothing just pops up. Nobody has, or like I said in my previous videos, they probably have but they don't want to sell it. And you guys know that this is my work truck, so I'm not too sure how much longer I can wait for one to pop up, because man, I've been using something else to work, and it's that thing right there. Don't look at it. But it's pretty hard because I can't like carry pipe if I need pipe, or carry my ladder. I have all my tools and my toolbox and stuff, and whatever I can carry in that thing is like limited. That's why it's a limited edition. So I'm just gonna bite the bullet and take the Tacoma to a shop. Turn on the water hose real quick and boom, ready to power wash this thing. I know I've pretty much been the kind of guy to like work on my own car and try to fix stuff that I could fix, but if I'm being honest with you guys, rebuilding a transmission is beyond my knowledge and capabilities, and I don't even have time to wash the truck. What makes you guys think I have time to rebuild a transmission? That would be a pretty good learning experience though, but I don't have time for that right now. But yeah, that's what I've been up to. Way to start my year, huh guys? Way to start my year. And I guess you guys could see how it is running polished wheels in the sand. But of course, do not be like me where you take it to the beach, take it back home, and don't clean it for like 3 days. Don't do that. Yeah. Here goes. Oh, never even turn them on. I told you guys that I'm gonna take my truck to a transmission shop. So I decided on Pro City Transmission. I heard they're pretty good. So we'll see how they do, and hopefully they can fix my transmission. I just wanna clean up down there for them, so they don't have to get too dirty, because down there is pretty dirty. So I'm just gonna spray. I usually use Super Power, the one in a purple bottle. I don't know if, or no, not Super Power, Super Clean, but they didn't have that. Both O'Reilly and AutoZone near where I live, so I just had to settle for this. walk the shock too. Make nice a little bit. Soak everything. Oh yeah, and by the way guys, if you guys took your truck in the sand, don't be like me and rinse and wash it right when you get home from the beach, because sand, beach, salt water, rust, especially here in Hawaii. Yeah. Sorry guys, I was literally trying to fix my truck right when I got home, and that night I got home maybe like around 8:30ish, and I didn't even sleep till like 2:30 the next day, and I had work like 3 hours later. But yeah, I already see all the dirt is falling. Pretty good stuff. So we washed that down and it sort of helped. I mean, at least it's better than before. We can see how many dirt came off. Well, kind of see it. Or like how many sand came off. Let's see how these wheels clean up after playing in the sand. Put some soap. Scrub them a little bit and scrub it a little bit. Scrub them. And here's cleaning the back wheel. So looks like it did pretty okay in the sand. Like there's not, well, there's no corroding or anything, or like haze. Well, I'm not too sure how it'll be when I dry it, but that's how it looks like so far. A lot of people DM me asking if the rims will get scratched, but I don't know, I never cleaned them yet. So we'll see right after this when it dries. After that, you get your blower and blow it. Then once water is minimal, you grab a clean microfiber and wipe it clean. I mean, wipe it dry. So, not too bad. You can still see the shine. But I'm noticing like some lines here. And to be honest, I'm not too sure whether those are from using the same rag as what I used to wash the truck, or if that was actually like the sand just spinning inside. But nothing a little aluminum polish won't fix. Let's try that right now. Put a lid on top, get your polishing rag, and get to polishing. Let's see how these do. And there you have it.
So I can see kind of like the haze over here, like lines compared to this area where we just polished. Thank you.
and it's gone.
Oh, pretty sure it's gone. Just a little bit more. Just to confirm.
So this is like the non-polished side, polished and non-polished. So that's one good thing about polished wheels, is that if you have like haze over here or like tiny scratches, whether it's from sand or using the wrong type of rag, don't at me, is you can just polish it with aluminum polish. Whereas like chrome wheels, you like chrome plated wheels, you can't really get that stuff out. So yeah. Alright, so the truck is done. It's pretty clean again. And ready to go to the transmission shop tomorrow. So it's getting pretty late and the sun is going down. The truck is clean and I pretty much just gotta empty out my tools and stuff that I need for work, because I don't know when's the next time I'm gonna see that truck. Depending on how long the shop will take, they're gonna get it towed there tomorrow, and just wishing for the best. If you guys were wondering how many miles I had on that transmission, I think it's at like 260 right now, because I pulled that trans off the four-wheel drive parts truck that I had, and I think it was like at 240 when I pulled it, and I put on like about 20,000 miles. So it's not bad for like 2 years. It did its job, and I think like just using it to tow cars and stuff just added more strain on the transmission, which caused it to like I guess have problems. It'd be pretty funny if they fix the trans and I go pick it up with my 240 and I tow my 240 back home with the truck. It's dumb, man. And then team break again. And we have a new goal for this year. If you guys remember that that quicksand Toyota Tacoma that we lifted like a year ago. This one right here. Prophecies that I made way back in the veil. Oh yeah, that one. Well, at his Instagram page, and he posted up that if we have 500 subscribers by June, then he'll get American Forces. That's an Yoda. It's my friend Kyle. This is his truck Instagram though. But yeah, give him a follow. Don't forget to subscribe. And 500 is quite a lot. But if you guys want to see some forces on this Nissan Toyota right here, hit that subscribe button. Don't forget to share our videos, shout us out, and spread the word. Help us get up to 500 subscribers by June, and let's be surprised. But yeah, thanks for watching, guys. I'll definitely keep you guys updated and let you guys know how it goes with the trans, the Tacoma and all. But yeah, guys, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.